Good morning, guys. Lillian with Lily Ray's Collection. Today I am going to paint this sketch that I did. I did this today. I've already gone over it with the black Faber-Castell, and we're going to be using, we're going to be using, these are the J.Davenport watercolors. These are the brights, these are the neutrals, and this set here is the Winsor & Newton, just in case. And then I have these two Faber-Castells that I may or may not use, not sure. But I thought it would shorten the video if I sketched things out and, you know, did the basics. So I'm going to start watercoloring, and this is 140 pound paper. I always forget to give the details. I do apologize. This is the Canson watercolor cold pressed paper, 9x12, and let's see what we can do here. Let's go ahead and watercolor does take a little longer, so I may pause. Actually, I should spray my, let me spray them. It seems that every time I get on camera, I forget what I need to do. And this is a cat's tongue that I'm using. It's a 3/4 faux squirrel by Zenart brush. I found out today that Alice's original color hair is black. Not blonde, and this story was established in 1865, which I put right there. I was trying to get as many details as I could find. Actually, let me just do all this. That's her ear right there. Let me know again in the comments below what you would like to see. I don't know if, you know, a long process video is what you guys would prefer to see, or to see the short ones. So let me know below. And also, I put out a video yesterday of a giveaway that I'm going to be doing once I reach 450 subscribers. So, and you have to leave a comment, because I use the YouTube random picker, and so that goes by comments. And I'm working on dry paper. I didn't wet the paper before because I want to make sure that I color what I want when I want. That doesn't run into that, doesn't bleed into that area. I like this brush because it's thick, pointy, and you could use it for really any purpose. Okay, so I'm gonna let her face dry and move on to something else. Now for these guys, I think I'm gonna need a small brush, I think. Let me see if I use I have this one. And that is a number 2. Let's see, I'm gonna do the Cheshire Cat, and I wanna do him in purple and pink. Now, I don't know that I'm gonna be able to get these lines not to bleed in, but we'll see. So we're going to start, that would be pink, this one's purple. I didn't include the rabbit. I just didn't feel like putting a rabbit in my painting, but I guess he's a big part of Alice, I don't know. And this, this Alice in Wonderland story is actually somewhat true. I believe that, I forget the gentleman's name, I should have written it down. He was babysitting. I just heard the story today. Babysitting and reading, telling, you know, stories to the kids before they went to bed. And I think it was Alice who asked him, after so many times of telling the same story, to write it down. And that's how the story of Alice in Wonderland began. And then Walt Disney eventually bought the rights, but as I understand it, Walt was not too enthused with this, not the story, but he wasn't too happy with, I forget what it was, the story, but eventually he bought the rights. And I know Jane Davenport is a big fan of Alice in Wonderland. So I'll be posting this on her page. I don't know if they allow you to post videos, but I'll have to ask Carrie. I was reading something that Karen Campbell was writing on her page, on her Facebook page, and we were all talking about how it's interesting, or rather ridiculous, that most Facebook pages have rules about what you can post and what you shouldn't post, or what you can sell, and just think it's ridiculous. But, you know, I think it's nice that we can all support. I hope my head's not in the way. I think it's nice that we can support one another. And I understand some people have to have that control, but I don't know. They take the fun out of everything. Let me see if I can take some of this water out. When I get up to 30 minutes, what I'm going to do is I'll stop and start the video again. So that if I have to split it into two, I'll split it into two. So I'm going to let that dry before I do the pink. So that it doesn't bleed. Okay. And now his face, I'm going to give him let's give him this color, like a mustard colored face. And then I'll make his hair brown. I think my brush is too juicy. to peek at the camera every now and then. Oops. See what happens when you're... Okay. I believe his eyelids are brown as well. His feet, his paws, his hands, see if I since I already have the brush wet. I'm sorry if I mumble. I'm trying not to mumble. Let's see if I can do his face like this. This one, I want to make his face just a little bit darker on this one. I'll use the Faber-Castell marker, the pit pen for his nose. I wanted to actually make his nose pink, but I want his nostrils to be black inside. So, I thought this was his nose. That's not his nose. That's where his whiskers are held. Let me see if I pick that up. Okay. This way I could make it pink with one of the Tombow markers once it dries. Okay. Good enough. Let's see. Yeah. I know I'll have to go over the purple. But for now, I'll try and do as much as I can, and then I can post pictures of the process. Oh, I forgot his arm there. This pink. And I know I'll have to give him a second coat for both colors. Okay, so while I'm here, it's starting to rain. It's supposed to pour this whole weekend. See what color we're going to make. Let's do the hat since it's down below here. The hat should be black, but I'm going to make it a blue. Actually, I'm going to make the hat gray. So it's going to be blue and purple. Is it blue and purple, or is it, no, it's purple and brown that make gray. Yeah, brown and blue make purple. Brown and blue make gray. Can you hear that rain? Wow. Finally got here. Okay. Let me... Oh, man. I think I'm going to have to use a smaller brush. I took my other brushes out of here. Nope. Give me a minute, I'll be right back. All right, what I went ahead and did, I completed these little, the small items, because it would have taken me longer to do it, to film it, and I would have had to have put my head in the way, because I have to be over it. But we have plenty to do, like the background, her hair, her lips, her skin is not complete. So, we're gonna do that now. So let's see. Let me use I was trying to just stay with the skin tones here, but I wanted her skin to blend nicely. And not too dark. Let's see if this is gonna work. Let's see, maybe just a little bit of this here. Okay, I'm gonna do once over with this color. I'm trying to get that nice and even so that when it dries, it's not too streaky. And I do have to do her neck. So we're going to do her neck. And I have to be very careful because the other one's a watercolor. That I don't hit that. Maybe I should put on my glasses. I hope my head's not in the way. Let me turn it upside down. Turn this one. And some of this one. this area here a bit darker. Almost finished, baby. I'm just going to make the whole neck dark because it has a lot going on, so I'm gonna say that all of that is shadowing the neck. Okay. Now I still have to I do want to leave this as a highlight, so I'm just putting clean water over it. See the highlight already on her nose as a profile. So now I have to darken her profile, which I'm going to use the same exact color with less water. It's going to be the same color. I think this is the first profile that I do. Hi, baby. What are you doing? Alright, so I decided to use my Tombow 026 for the last highlight, and what I will do is these are also water soluble, so I will dilute that just a little bit. And I am going to use some pencils, and what I will do is I will put some pictures up of my last steps when I do the pencils and all of that, because it's going to take too long. You know, it's not a quick just watercolor and be done with it. Okay, so I'm going to use this brush, and I just sop up the water from the back of the brush, and that seems to take a lot of the water out. But the brush is still, you know, see, pretty juicy. I want to be able to blend those two lines. And the hair, I decided that I'm going to give her red burgundy hair. I don't want her as a blonde, because all of this is just going to blend in too much. So, and I don't want to go black. I could go black because it'll make everything stand out. But I think I prefer the red. See, that color was a perfect match for her neck. See that? Okay, I'm gonna let this dry. And then I'm going to do her hair. I think I need to dry this before I do her hair. Ow. Let me get my heat gun. I'm gonna do her hair, and then, you know, I will fix up her face because I'm not done yet. I don't know if I should keep recording. I don't know what you guys really want. Let me do her face one more time. Definitely not satisfied with it. Do it with a light touch, a light hand. But you don't, even though this is watercolor paper, it can peel. trying to pick up a hair there that of course you guys can't see, but I could see. Okay, I'm going to leave it like that for now. Now let me turn this around. I don't know, I think I'm going to use this. I'm going to use this one, so I'm going to use this red. And of course, the burgundy. Add more water, and of course we're going to layer this. Okay, I'm not going to put it too close to the edge there. I have to finish my clock. I'm going to continue with this and I will be back.